Today we're here in sunny Cornwall because the Duchy Agricultural College have invited us along to have a look around their farm and see what they're doing to increase efficiency.
We're here at Future Farm at Duchy College. This unit was opened in 2020, so we've been here 3 years now, and we have 220 cows in the unit.
87% of UK ammonia emissions are from farming, and that is a loss of nitrogen to the air, which is a valuable fertiliser. In the UK, 27% of farmer ammonia emissions are from livestock housing, like this shed here, and a further 25% are from spreading manures, which we'll look into in a bit more detail as we go around.
The flooring here was deliberately designed to reduce ammonia emissions, and the idea of the longitudinal lines are to keep the urine separate from the faeces. And we also have slats here so that it's not open to the air so much and reduces ammonia emissions.
Here we use automatic scrapers to get rid of our slurry that's in within the cubicles. They run every 3 hours, 24 hours a day. We run them that often because we like to remove the slurry as quick as we can and get it away from the cows, which we also believe helps reduce emissions and ammonia buildup.
Dairy farms can reduce ammonia and methane by improving slurry management and changing cow diets, with additional financial savings and livestock health benefits. If crude protein levels in feed exceed 16% for the whole cow diet, then the nitrogen is not absorbed and simply comes out the back end of a cow. So reducing crude protein down to 16% will save money without reducing productivity or fertility.
We've been doing feed trials looking into reducing the carbon footprint of the feed, so reducing the use of soya, so we can reduce carbon footprints without negative effects, so making a more efficient dairy system.
Methane is a very potent greenhouse gas, therefore using it as a resource rather than releasing it to atmosphere is far more beneficial for the farm and the environment. Ammonia and methane can be lost from dung passages as well as from the slurry store, so here additives are added to the slurry channels under the dung passages to reduce these emissions.
We're particularly using slurry additives to see if we can improve nitrogen efficiency, keeping the nitrogen in the slurry and then looking at its effect on the soil and the following crop, in this case, improved yields of silage. We currently have four storage tanks for our slurry. They don't have covers, and our aspiration would be to look for a Benjamin type cover so that we can capture methane from the slurry.
Specialist slurry covers, such as a Benjamin cover, are designed to capture the methane emissions, which can then be used to power a generator to provide all of the farm's energy needs, or be processed further and used as a gas or even converted to a liquid to power vehicles.
We use contractors to do all our spreading. We generally use umbilical tanking where we can get to the farm where we're not crossing roads. But a lot of our arable block is further off away from the farm and where the cows are, where livestock are, so we generally tend to use nurse tanker there. We generally use that so we can keep compaction down on the ground. The contractors use a dribble bar, prefer that to a splash plate, just helps keep ammonia emissions down and we get more targeted slurry on where we need it.
Farmers have been faced with rising production costs, while the price they are paid for their outputs has also fallen, so there is a need to improve efficiency to remain viable. We've had a good look round this farm to see what action they're doing to reduce nutrient losses to air, which shows where CSF advice can improve farm efficiency and better the environment. See the links for further advice, and thanks for listening.